I tell my kids, I tell them all the time, oh, you should be a teacher. I wanted to become a teacher because all throughout my life, teachers were really, really important to me. I remember every single elementary school teacher I ever had. I remembered that teachers loved me and told me that I'm not like the rest of them. It never occurred to me who the rest of them were.
Ms. Scott recognizes, in particular in terms of mathematics, that it is a gatekeeper. And she insists that all students have the ability and the power to cross through that gate. And she addresses that, particularly with her students of color, explicitly, recognizing that the gate is intended to be closed for some, and she refuses to let that happen to her students.
I distinctly remember being a dark-skinned black girl my whole time through school. When I got into the College of Education at Wayne State, a lot of times in the math curriculum, I was once again the only black person in the school, and it baffled me because Wayne State is in the heart of Detroit, a predominantly black city, and I could not believe in my soul or literally that it's just me. And that made no sense to me, that in my class, my math education courses, it was just me. In education, I've always had to fight that you don't know that much because you're a black female. I wanted to be a teacher in the city of Detroit because I needed kids who looked like me. The one thing that always goes through my head is my mom said, you're not special, you just haven't found anyone like you. You're not an anomaly. There are tons of people like you. And what I believe is that our kids don't know what's out there. Most of my friends grew up right here in the city of Detroit, on the east side, on the west side, you know, in Brightmoor, in the neighborhoods where my kids come from.
I feel like she it's not just all about throwing pieces of paper and work and stuff in front of students and expecting them to just do it. I feel like she's actually really preparing her students for any further education that they choose to go for. As a student of color, Ms. Scott has supported me by showing me and giving me advice from the years that she's been teaching black men, encouraging us and letting us know that there is a different path and there's a different environment to thrive in other than the one you were raised in.
She's the most loving, caring teacher of them all. She's the most dedicated teacher here because even with the pandemic and everything going on, she still reaches out to me even though I don't have her class. I don't have her as a teacher right now, but she still reaches out to make sure that I'm still on the right track, making sure that I'm getting all my goals and everything done. And she helped me whichever way is possible.
I first wanted to become an urban educator when I met Janine Scott. She was my teacher. She was my computer science teacher at Wayne State University. And I remember that her passion and her excitement for her own school was just so incredible that I really felt like I could do what she wanted me to do. So I went and I really felt a moment of like this is where I'm supposed to be. And Janine was really critical in mentoring that.
So I have students who've become teachers. And one thing that they do when they become teachers is they call me back up and say, Ms. Scott, you're right. I love this.
My name is Corey Madden, and I want to say thank you to my proud Michigan educators.
My name is Tatiana Canty, and I am proud of my Michigan educators.
My name is Monica McLeod, and I am a proud Michigan educator.
My name is Allison McGee, and I'm a proud Michigan educator.
My name is Janine Scott, and I'm a proud Michigan educator.